This episode of Daily One Update is brought to you by the U.S. Air Force.
Hi, this is your Daily One Update for August 17th, 2010. I'm Scott Sharkey.
And I'm Tina Sanchez.
Yeah. I'm too happy.
Yes. Because Ratchet & Clank Alpha 1 was announced today. So it's coming out. Everyone knows about it now. It's being developed by the North Carolina studio, though.
Yep, that's their new one.
Which is interesting. Yeah. But it will, you know, have four-player co-op, and you get to play as Ratchet, Clank, Nefarious, and Quark.
Quark, yes.
Yeah.
So, yeah, drop-in, drop-out co-op. I'm pretty happy about that. Also, I have All for Love stuck in my head now, and that's a kind of hell I haven't experienced since the 90s. You're too young for that.
All right, but the release date is in November 2011, and they also announced Resistance 3. Be excited.
Very excited.
Yes.
Absolutely.
But I really want to play Ratchet & Clank. That should be fun.
Oh. Also, Mass Effect 2 is coming to the PlayStation 3, finally. Which is great, except there's no Mass Effect 1 coming to PlayStation. So, well, because it's published by Microsoft Game Studios.
Yeah.
So that's never going to happen. So I don't know how character importing is going to work or if that's even going
maybe
to exist.
Maybe they just dropped that entirely.
They might, or maybe if you're really lucky, they'll let you just sort of pick your background. You know, I was a Paragon first time through, as opposed to just sort of the. Well,
actually,
I think it defaulted to Paragon, didn't it? I can't remember. It's been a while. Anyway, so we don't know how that's going to work yet. So it'll probably be a simultaneous launch when Mass Effect 3 comes out. I'm willing to bet.
I see. So.
Also,
the exclusive.
Yes, we have an exclusive video of a WiiWare game coming out. It's Retro City Rampage. And you really have to see this thing. This is neat. It's kind of like if GTA were made for the NES, but it also combines all these other little nods to games. There's like the damn stage in Ninja Turtles. We could probably get that in there. There's a Bionic Commando bit. Frank was saying it's like you remember the bit in Who Framed Roger Rabbit when you drive into Toontown?
Yes.
It's like that with 80s video games.
Interesting.
Yeah, it's just this weird conglomeration thrown into like kind of this weird open worldy sort of thing.
And we have the exclusive trailer.
Yep.
Take that, other sites. Sweet.
And?
Another favorite trailer that I liked today was at the Epic Mickey opening cutscene. I don't know if you watched it. I see it.
I have not yet.
Last night. Oh man, it's adorable. But it's also kind of scary at the same time too, because you have like these evil blobs that just grab Mickey. And I would imagine it's kind of terrifying for like a 5-year-old to watch.
I'm just thrilled to see Mickey in a video game not wearing a trench coat and being all emo. This is a good mood for him.
Hmm.
Did you play Kingdom Hearts?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, there was like a Latin choir chanting in the background. He destroyed the Earth, I think. I don't really remember.
Well, anyways, this cutscene is really cute, so we better watch it.
Yep.
A long time ago, on a very peculiar day, my mirror lured someone out of his bed and opened a doorway to my workshop. I do not know if the mirror was being mischievous or malicious. Perhaps it knew that the curious intruder had a role to play in my project. I was putting the finishing touches on my latest creation. A world for things that have been forgotten. Satisfied with my progress, I put the magic brush down and retired to my chambers. Had I known what events would follow, I would have locked away everything. Paint, brush, and thinner.